Right, guys and girls, so the Kral Pancha Big Max X come from Turkey, and must say, this has gone really did surprise me, and it left quite an impression on me. It's an excellent bang for buck. So, in the plastic carry case, there comes a bipod with adjustable legs and stuff. And you can also use it as a monopod, fit it underneath on the Picatinny. So that's that. It comes with two rotary type 12 shot magazines. It comes with a single loader. On the bottom side there's a Picatinny rail, and there's a threaded insert where you can fit the extra Picatinny rail should you wish to. Then also on the bottom side is the full port and the gauge. The trigger itself, I did not adjust it. It came very light from the factory, and I must say I was pleasantly surprised by how smooth the trigger is. Safety is on the side, it's nice and functional, does its job. The butt piece at the back can adjust. There's an adjustment screw, so you can move it front to the front and backwards, and as well as the butt pad itself, you just depress this button and then you move the butt pad up and down. On top it has a Picatinny rail for the scope mounts. The scope itself is a T-Eagle 2-16x44 second focal plane. Pretty damn nice scope. Glass is exceptionally good, and must say, very positive clicks and stuff. Nice scope, I like it. On the front there is a half inch UNF fret for muzzle, for the silencer. This guy's got quite a bark to him, so I would suggest putting on a silencer. And in a nutshell, that's about that. I will put the crony results and stuff in with the amounts of shots that we get from a full. And it's heavy, but it's not insanely heavy. Shoulders nice, and overall it's a comfortable gun. So let's go shoot some groups and see how it does. Given the fact that the gun isn't regulated, we found that the optimum fill pressure was at 200 bar down to 130 bar, and we got 64 usable shots. Alright, so we're gonna do the 50 meter grouping and see how it goes. Even at 51 can see there's a fair amount of wind. Die down a little bit now. So I lost track of the amount of shots. Not sure whether that was 5. Let's shoot another one. Awesome, stacked them nicely on top of each other almost at 50. Pretty damn pretty group. Awesome stuff. Alright, guys and girls, so we're quickly going to shoot a grouping at 100 meters. And we're going to use the knockouts. It's in 2.178 size. So let's see how it goes. There's a slight breeze. Let's see. See, it's only the wind having an effect. The line is the line is precise, so looking good. Maybe let's try and shoot another 5. You can see on the flag there is quite a lot of wind. Nevertheless, I think the grouping is I really think the grouping is looking excellent. This gun is doing pretty damn good with the knockout slugs at 100 meters. So if you want a slug gun from Kral, this is it. Alright guys and girls, so just for the fun of it, I've put up some steel targets at 125 meters. So let's see how it goes. They're about average, I think, the size of a 500 tin of pellets. But I'll put a photo in with it so that you can reference to it. So let's see. There's a bit of wind. I'm just gonna adjust for it. Awesome. Awesome stuff. they're all down.